Welcome to a new video where I want to talk about the Sony Xperia 1 Mark III. And if I want to keep it short, what I want to say is in this video, 30 watt charging, 8 megapixel front camera updated, and a video zoom only on one lens possible, and better stabilization in video 4K. So this is the two long to watch short version. Let's get on with the long version. A few days ago, Sony had an event in Russia where they presented new hardware, new cameras and other stuff as well, amongst a nice little phone, the Xperia 1 Mark III. I have the 1 Mark II here, but what I can tell you right now are some of the changes and impressions that I got from this one, because someone was there filming it, and he filmed also the Xperia 1 Mark III and had a very interesting impression. First of all, what we will see, what will definitely happen, is we will have the dedicated Google Assistant button that will be able to be remapped, and it will be recessed just like on the Xperia 5 Mark II, where it is also a bit recessed so you cannot easily hit it, just like the button for taking the shutter button. So this one is a little bit, it's smallish here, it's bigger, way bigger on the Xperia 1 Mark III, and has this some kind of pattern so you can easily feel the shutter button. And then of course it will also have I think slightly bigger fingerprint reader, also a bit recessed as well, so you don't hit it by accident, and you can put this onto a nice little selfie stick or smartphone holder, which is also very important, I think. Then what we will have as well is we saw a little bit of glimpse of the camera software, and one of the interesting things that I saw there was that it is now possible to record video with the basic camera application that is just basically Photo Pro in a basic mode. So it will also have the ability to take videos, which I think last time already mentioned. But the cool thing is that you have now the possibility to also zoom with this camera application. It has a zoom option, but this zoom option is just like as bad as the zoom option here on the Xperia 1 Mark II's basic Sony app, because you don't have the option to zoom in fully, the full range of all the sensors. You cannot use them. You have to just rely when you can see it in the video material. As soon as he hits the record button, all those little zoom options and different camera sensors that you can use disappear, and you only have a slider that allows you to slowly and smoothly zoom in, which is for video of course what you want, but only for one lens. So you don't have the option to go through different lenses. Again, this is a limitation that I don't know why, Sony. Why do we have this limitation? I don't like this limitation at all. Other manufacturers don't have this limitation. Please get rid of it until the final version is out, because I want to switch and smoothly zoom as good as possible through all the camera lenses if it is possible. Then of course you have also the possibility to zoom in digitally, probably between the 75 to 105 periscope variable zoom. This is a feature that I think was only possible that it's like switching from 75 to 105, but in the video it looked like you're zooming like pretty much digital probably, but it looks like optically zooming, so I'm not sure. Maybe Sony did something to make it even better looking in digital zoom. That would be also one possibility that we have here. Then what I also liked is the Xperia 1 Mark II and Xperia 1 always were criticized for their fingerprint reader that was like slightly bad. But I think the 1 Mark II improved it a lot, and I think the 1 Mark III will improve it even better. It will have an even better fingerprint reader. Another critique point was the front-facing camera, 8 megapixels only on the Xperia 1 Mark II and on the Xperia 1 Mark I, and it will be probably the same sensor, at least on spec sheet it looks like the same sensor. But I think they have a different coating on top of the glass for the lens area, where it will not have this problems with sun shining, and you have this glare, sun glare effect. So I think they will also work on this. And what they did definitely is improve the software. Could be mainly because Photo Pro is now used in a basic mode for allowing you to have less noise in the shot and better colors slightly. And I think they're cropping in a little bit as well. And you might have a nice bokeh effect as well with the front-facing camera, which is also pretty nice and an interesting improvement for the Sony Xperia 1 Mark III. And then my little cheat sheet, what did I write down? Better 4K video stabilization. You can see I'm running around with my Fujifilm XS10 to try out a new setup, a new microphone, wireless microphone, and to see if this is workable as, or doable as a vlogging kit. And you can see that stabilization probably is not the best. It's not as good as with a smartphone, but still should be fine for this kind of vlogging shots. On the Xperia 1 Mark III, we will have even a better stabilization system. Finally, Sony listened, because the Xperia 1 Mark II, it is not competing with similar flagships in terms of stabilization. Full HD maybe, but 4K definitely not. And it's good to see an improvement here as well with the Xperia 1 Mark III. Then the next thing that I saw, and which no one really mentioned, is that the Xperia 1 Mark III will have a 30-watt charger. I don't think it will be included. Maybe it will be included in the box, which would be awesome, because then you have the option to fast charge. It will even beat the Samsung flagships that only have 24 watts charging right now. And I think it's a good compromise between this super 66, 67 watt charger and charging speed, and the 30, 33 watt the Xiaomi, for example, has, which is still fast enough. I think this is a good step in the right direction for Sony for the charging speeds. It's not charging too quickly, so the battery would go kaput in a few weeks or years, and it is, I think, enough for the device to be quick in charging speeds, that it isn't annoying if you just want to plug it in and just wait for 15 minutes and so on and go out then. So this is basically everything that I have for this little Sony update video about the 1 Mark III. Then what I heard is, I think end of June, the device should appear in Russia. And I think there were some rumors, and I think the Sony 365 channel already posted a release date of 20th of May for Hong Kong, which would be also awesome, I would say. But why is this discrepancy a few months there? I don't get it. Maybe Sony wants to have one group testing it already, like the tech-savvy Hong Kong people. And then after 1 month, they will fix all the bugs that they report, and then they can release this in Russia. And if Russia has all the bugs fixed, then we will have an European release, and probably then a lot later an American, US-American release. I'm not sure what Sony is thinking about this. I want to have the release as soon as possible and want to try out the device, but I can accept, of course, waiting 1 or 2 months if the software is then polished, if you have the possibility to plug in microphones directly and use it with the default camera application, and control it, maybe even the microphone in the default camera application, for example. If Sony would be compatible with Sony wireless microphones, just like this one here, is what I'm testing right now, Sony ECM W2BT. There will be an unboxing coming soon. And this one just plugged into the Sony Xperia 1 Mark II or 5 Mark II, but I don't get any audio out of it, even with a TRRS adapter. So it would be nice if this would be solved as well with the 1 Mark III or a software update on the 1 Mark II. And or the device itself. Maybe it does need to have an extra mode for phones. This is basically everything for the Xperia 1 Mark III rumors and speculations and leaks video and everything that I figured out right now. And if you have some comments, questions, or some other leaks or rumors that you want to show me, you can write them down in the comment section. That's everything for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.